Welcome to the Branching Out podcast, everybody. Episode 2. Oh my lord, you've kept going. Thank you very, very much for tuning in. Or if this is your first time tuning in, that's crazy. This is episode 2. Go back. No, you're okay. Thank you. Thanks for sticking by. It's a great guest you've chosen to listen to. My guest today is Andrew Hamilton. One of the best going at the moment, guys. He's a Sydney-based comedian. You'd know him from his prison food reviews on TikTok. You can check him out, Andrew Hamilton Comedy on Instagram. You'd also know him from YeahmadTV. He's got his own podcast, the Flog Cabin podcast, that you can check out. And Andrew is just a golden retriever of a person. Absolute gem. His super villain backstory, if you really want to know. Let's gossip about him on the podcast. This is now a gossip podcast. You can get all your information here about any guest. DM me, it's going to be great. His supervillain backstory: he went to prison for the large supply of magic mushrooms, and then became a stand-up comedian, and he is flourishing. Well, and he deserves it. Seriously, just an all-round great guy. Besides the villainy, is he a superhero or a supervillain? let's find out. Thank you very, very much for tuning into the podcast. I hope you get some great recommendations. For any first listeners, this is the Branching Out podcast. It's encouraging people to branch out more in life. This is Andrew's recommendations. I hope you enjoy them all. It was one of my favorite episodes to record. Thank you to Andrew for coming on the podcast, and thank you for letting me talk about you behind your back. I hope you're hearing this, and I hope you're a great guy. thank you very much. Have a great episode, listeners. Get home safe. Thank you.
Are we recording? Are we on?
We are recording, but I figured
we are having fun.
We are testing the levels. This sounds good.
All right. What's the name of your podcast?
It's the Branching Out podcast.
Branching Out.
It's encouraging people to branch out into different things, you know?
Oh my God. Is that the best you got?
It's a bit lame, which is the nicest way to say that.
Lame. and what was the premise about profits raised? It's going to something lame?
Yes, exactly. Every dollar that the podcast makes, a tree gets planted in the world. Very exciting stuff.
Oh, my God. Well, for every podcast that comes out, I'm also going to cut down a tree.
yeah. Just a big lumberjack axe and you're just going out. having a go. As people, welcome to the Branching Out podcast, ladies and gentlemen.
How many episodes have you done so far?
One episode before this with Chris Ryan. And it was a banger.
Well... was that yesterday?
That was yesterday in a car. And now we're in the office of the Newcastle Comedy Club. What do you think of it?
Sorry that you could go from the lofty heights of Chris Ryan to then have Andrew Hamilton.
Andrew Hamilton, a convicted comedian. is that a fun way to say it?
Felon and comedian, yes.
Yes, beautiful stuff. You might have heard him on Yeah Mad TV.
Oh my God.
You might have heard him at the Melbourne Comedy Festival, every other festival. Did you see that desk just start moving up? It's a stand-up desk that you can move
Oh my gosh, technology these days.
I bumped it with my arm and it just started moving up, ladies and gentlemen. What a nightmare. Let's start the podcast off nice and loud. I like to start the podcast by asking the guest, what is your favorite joke of all time? Can you please tell us your favorite joke of all time, Andrew Hamilton?
Well, I think because I used to be a drug addict, I think one
of... I bumped the desk yet again. I'm moving away.
I used to be a huge Mitch Hedberg fan when I was younger. One of my favorite ones was just, I used to do drugs. I still do, but I used to too.
One of the best of all time. Thank you very much, Andrew Hamilton. And we'll leave it at that. That's a great little... the way to start the podcast. Check out Mitch Hedberg, everyone. The man, if you haven't seen
him. I mean, he's dead now, but yeah, yes. You can check out his amazing stuff on YouTube.
You can't buy tickets, but you can Google him. Mm-hmm. What a great time. Andrew, what is your favorite thing about the world? It can be anything from sunsets to rainbow birds to women. It can be whatever you want to say, brother. What's your favorite thing? I want to inspire people to start noticing different things about the world. Because we walk around... We're just walking past stuff every day. It's normal to us
now. What did Chris Ryan say? I bet it was like some really deep felt, heartfelt answer.
Couldn't tell you it was that boring. No, I'm messing around. My memory is short term. Like a goldfish.
What do I like about the world? Mm. I like food. Yep. I like beers. Yep. I like the fact that we can rebuild ourselves after massively fucking up. You know, I like redemption, obviously.
Damn, redemption and beer. What a combo. Yeah, I'm all for that. That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Good. That's all I want to know. Thank you very much. What is your favorite song at the moment? I'm going to play it at the end of the podcast to ask people to branch out into different forms of music.
Oh, man. Oh, I'm really been getting into my country music.
Beautiful.
At the moment. So, mm-hmm.
Which country? Bit of fun.
Zing! So, Morgan Wallen or Luke Combs.
Yep.
I mean, it's crazy. Like, Luke Combs with Fast Car was a song that came out. Now, and he's gotten higher on the charts than Tracy Chapman ever did with the original.
Oh, really? That's really funny. That's a great bit to trump the first person. Just
Black woman does the song, can't go that well. But if you give it to a white American man...
Doing a cover. Stealing it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, which is a bit shit. But yeah, that's a great song.
What was the song one more time? So Luke Combs, Car?
Fast Car.
Fast Car. Beautiful stuff.
Luke Combs.
I'll put the song at the end of the podcast. I actually haven't checked out the copyright laws about that, but I'm going to give it a go. And if I go to prison over this, that's fine.
I'll give you some tips for it, mate. You'll be fine.
Yeah, I'll do another show. Things about the time I went to prison or something like that. Bit of fun.
That's an award winner.
That's beautiful. Next question of the time. What would you like to do before you die, Andrew Hamilton?
Oh, like four chicks at the same time?
That's very fun. Hell yeah, brother. Good shit. That's all I wanted, you know? That's beautiful. I'm asking listeners to branch out into four chicks at one time. And
what else? I mean, I've done skydiving. I've done bungee jumping. Yep. What's something else like adventurous I'd like to do? I would like to get my skydiving license so I could jump without being the pussy with like someone attached to your back.
Yeah. You cradling know? You. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So. That's good. That would probably be something. I'd like to travel a bit more.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a lot of parts of the world that I'd like to see. I'd like to go to Spain, I think.
Yep.
What
do you like about Spain?
I like Spanish food and Spanish women and Spanish wine.
Wow.
It seems like three good reasons, right?
Yeah, damn. I've only just computed that when people talk about speaking Spanish, that also relates to Spain, the actual place.
Wow.
For some reason, I always associate it with... How do you say Latino, that kind of stuff? Yeah. I didn't know that they were also Spanish, Spain and Spanish, but that's so funny.
You're hanging out with Hispanics in America, and then you go to Spain, and you're like, oh my God, whoa. They speak the same language. Yeah. Crazy.
Literally, I've only just made that connection 2 seconds ago.
Wow.
That's very funny.
All right, welcome to the real world, mate.
I'm learning these things, you know? No one tells you about these things. You're supposed to know, apparently.
They speak Spanish in Spain.
Beautiful stuff.
But they got amazing tapas food right over there. I don't know. Yeah, I'd love to go there.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Great stuff. Check out Spain, everyone. Mm. Recommended by Andrew Hamilton, who hasn't been there yet, but he's planning to because that was the question. Anyway.
And it's one of those countries I'm allowed into, right? So I have to be more selective with our countries now.
Did you get banned from countries for...
Well, with a criminal record, it's much harder to get into England and America are probably the two hardest.
Yep.
So I'll have to figure that out. At some stage, I'll have to hope I have a good immigration lawyer.
Mm.
But yeah, I think for now, I'm more likely to head to places in Asia or Eastern or broader Europe.
Yep.
Yeah, they're less strict than... I think US and England are the hardest.
Beautiful. Damn. I had no idea that you can get banned from other countries for that.
Yeah, well...
For something you've done in another country.
Well, I mean, a lot of countries... Like, Australia has some of those strict rules as well.
Yeah, true.
It's about your criminal record. I think I'm fine still to go into New Zealand. There's certain rules on how much jail time you're allowed to have done.
Right. Interesting.
And I only did 4 months, so I should be okay.
Yeah, good stuff.
Beautiful. I mean, you see Spanian travelling everywhere, and he's done a lot more jail than me. And there's plenty of guys that I have... That I know that have done a lot of prison that still be that I still see on Instagram traveling the world. So there's hope for us all.
Can Spaniard go to Spain? That's the real.
I think he can actually. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Damn it. Well, you can make it, brother. There you go. You've done it. And the final question of the podcast, Andrew. If the entire world is listening right now, which I'm hoping to get to that level, what do you want to tell them? Bit of advice. Bit of just a statement. You can go bleh, 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 into the camera. Do whatever you want, brother.
Look, life is short, you know, and I think that I am lucky that I get to do amazing things with comedy and all the amazing friends that I have through comedy, including yourself, because my life went to shit, and because that gave me an opportunity to really reflect on how shitty my life was and do something about it. And so for a lot of people, they don't really turn things around until they have a crisis point in their life, right? Until things go to shit.
Right.
Then they're like, oh, this sucks. Life is short. I should go and do the things that make me happy. But there are a lot of people that go through life without having a major crisis point, and so they just go through life just comfortable, right? And so
complacent.
They have a relationship that's not amazing and a job that they don't really like, and then they get to 80 and they look back and they regret it. So I would just say to you, maybe sometimes, maybe the biggest crisis you'll have in your life is that you don't have a major crisis and you need to go and make yourself happy because life is short.
I think that's beautiful. Thank you very much for coming on the podcast, Andrew Hamilton. Where can people find more of you?
Just Google Andrew Hamilton Comedy. Yep. I'm on Instagram, YeahmadTV, TikTok, whatever, probably at your local pub.
Hell yeah, brother. It's been an honor. Thank you very much.
No worries at all, bro.
Have a great night, everyone.